lots and lots of fights tonight.
Yeah. See, four more to go. And here comes Antonio Jackson. He's here for business. Talked to him a little bit earlier, and he said, I didn't drive all the way from Decatur, Illinois, to get a loss. You can see the determination in his eyes, and here he comes. Flexing already. Looks like he's ready to go.
And he looks fired up.
He looks very focused. Another question there, fighter. You see, he comes from a gym that says there's submission. Obviously, you got to think immediately, this guy wants to go to the ground.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Pedigo, submission, fighting is the camp that he comes from. His name, Santonio Jackson. A blue corner, patiently awaiting now his opponent, Luis Gil. As he'll make his way to the cage. What do you know about these guys? I mean, we've seen Luis. You know, we know he's a top-notch fighter himself. So Santonio, I don't think we've seen him yet, but he's going to have his hands full with Luis here tonight.
Santonio's got a lot of experience. He's got 5 amateur fights already. That's a lot as an amateur.
Right. I think they're setting things up for a pretty good fight here. We'll have to wait and see what happens. There he comes. He's ready. Look at the American Pit Fighters with him. There's Cody Knapp, Dave Mann, Tony Nixon. I see Joe Estrada back there. They are a team. They're 100% behind their lightweight, Luis Gil. Set the table for this 155-pound lightweight contest. Get things started. Here's ring announcer Nick Ryan.
Ladies and gentlemen, your first mixed martial artist fighting from the blue corner stands at 5'8" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds, and representing Pinnacle Submission Fighting and Fighting out of Decatur, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, Santonio Jackson. And now fighting from the red corner, standing at 5'6" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds, and representing Man's Hit to Fit and the American Pit Fighter and Fighting from Burlington, Iowa. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Luis
Gil. Your referee for this fight is Zach Titus.
Nick Ryan getting the crowd fired up here Saturday night. And here we go. Fight number 8 on the card. Santonio Jackson, Luis Gull, 155 pounds. Here we go, partner.
Luis is always bringing it. I know you look at his record, and it's a little deceiving because he is 0-3, but he is always bringing the fight.
Oh, Luis in the black trunks, Santonio in the white trunks, and they're clinched up. Santonio trying to hammer fist as Luis clinches on against the fence here in opening action of this lightweight contest.
Now, Luis has got a great grip on Santonio right now. Doesn't have his hands locked. Santonio's going to get out of there, yep.
Back to the stand-up. Santonio, leg kick misses. Luis missed one earlier. There's another kick. Feeling each other out.
Oh, nice leg kicks.
You can see the speed in which these two are going at it. These are highly trained fighters. Just tell the quickness. Bounce off their feet. Santonio's all over the place.
And Santonio's kicks are looking real good. He's landing them from both angles, left and right.
Combination there, got a leg kick in. There's another leg kick.
Luis checked that kick. That's good.
Educated feet. Both of these lightweights here. True ref 57. Sport has just come so far in such a quick. I've been part of this sport for maybe, I don't know what it's been, 12, 13 years, and it has come so far just in that short amount of time.
Oh, it absolutely has.
It's great to see all over the country, and of course, the bloodline, the heartbeat of MMA is right here along the banks of the Mississippi.
Oh,
Iowa. There, he's got him to the ground. Santonio. Got Luis in big trouble here. Throwing combinations against the fence. Luis is able to get some space and get back.
And Luis took a few punches in there. And he's still there, though. Still with it.
40 seconds to go here. Round number 1. Again, Santonio in the white trunks. Luis in the black trunks. Live from the sold-out Burlington Memorial Auditorium in Burlington, Iowa. Exciting first round. Near the end of this first round. Probably give this first round. Nice knee. So the first round goes to Santonio Jackson.
Yeah, Santonio's really landing some punches in there.
There's the horn, end of round number 1. And I think we both agree that first round probably goes to Santonio Jackson, but Luis Gull, of course, will give it back in round number 2.
Now, Santonio came to his corner with his mouth wide open, looking for air, so. I don't know if that's going to be a factor, but it's definitely he came to his corner mouth wide open.
Tell us what you see. Well, with this action we're seeing in these replays here, of course he's tired.
Yeah, he really put on a lot of effort into this first round here. You can see him landing kicks left and right.
There's a kick.
Luis with a nice kick there.
There's another nice one that we saw. Three plays, of course, provided from the guys back in the truck at Broken Centrifuge Productions. But right there, thought we had Luis hurt, but Luis able to fight through it, get back up. That's what it's all about.
Now, Luis is always game. He always brings the fight.
He'll bring it here as we get ready for round number 2.
And he's always got good cardio, so if you look at Jackson now, his mouth's wide open.
Wide open. Like me going up 2 flights of stairs. Back underway here, round number 2. Lightweight contest. Santonio Jackson in the white trunks. Luis Gull in the black trunks. Hometown favorite is Luis. Scorecards have him down after round number 1. Santonio a little bit taller, a little longer reach. And he's using it to his advantage here.
And that can play a big difference, having that reach advantage, especially if you find that sweet spot where you can get to them and they can't get to you.
Inside leg kick from Santonio lands on Luis's inside left leg. Luis can't just seem to get there.
Every punch Luis throws just falling short. It's barely, but it's falling short.
Another kick from Santonio lands. There's a kick back from Luis, lands on the right leg. Exchanging kicks for these fighters.
Luis to switch stances. Now he's back to the regular stance.
When you see a fighter do that, is that because they're panicking?
And switch stance, usually a lot of times with these leg kicks that I'm seeing, that's what it's coming from.
It's a shot that rocks.
Getting tired of getting hit in that leg. Switches up, get the other leg, just take some punishment.
This crowd gets into it here in the Burlington Memorial Tournament. These two fighters continue to trade shots.
Yeah, these guys are just trading back and forth. Nice leg kick. Nice right hook. Luis looking good in this round.
Shove. 1 minute to go here in round number two. Both these fighters continue to try to establish seniority or dominance in this second round. There's a kick to the midsection, followed with a combination punch to the face. Another one. And another. Right.
Now, Santonio's using his reach advantage very well.
How do you combat that? You go to the ground if you're Luis.
I'm surprised Luis hasn't tried to take down Santonio at this point.
Maybe in round number three, as we're nearing the end of round number two. Still time. About 20 seconds or so. Here at True Rev 57.
He's shown a few feints on level changes, but he hasn't actually changed levels and went for that takedown yet.
Both fighters exchanging kicks at the end of round two. Wild kick misses from Santonio, and there we go. Two rounds down, one to go.
Deep breaths from Santonio Jackson again as he enters his corner. But he doesn't look like he's slowing down. He definitely looks like he's needing more air, but he is not slowing down.
Fast-paced action, round number two. Here we go. Talk us through some of these replays, partner.
You know, Santonio's landing these left hands, these left straights every single time he's throwing them. It's almost a half Superman punch that he's throwing. Nice leg kicks by Luis.
Right on the hip. There was at the very end of the round. Great job by the guys back in the booth. As we're ready for round number three. So, all right, so set the table here. What do you think both fighters need to do in this final round?
Luis needs to get a finish here.
Santonio, you mentioned that mouth is wide open. He doesn't appear to be too tired.
I'm wondering if this is something he does, because I noticed throughout the whole round two, his mouth was wide open. So I don't know if this is something he does, but you notice it's wide open right now.
Santonio's got a huge knot on his left foot. He just kind of rubbed on it before this round started. We'll see if that comes into play. And it is a big knot on his left foot. All right, so here we go. Round number three, final round. This three-round amateur contest in the lightweight division at True Rev 57. Luis Gil in the black trunks. Santonio Jackson in the white trunks. Luis tries to shoot. He's got a leg. Can he get him down?
He does. Right. That's a nice takedown by Luis. He's got to do something with it, though. He's going to get caught in this triangle. So you want to have both arms in this position. Either both arms in or both arms out. You never want one arm in. It leaves you open for triangle or armbar.
Santonio fighting from the bottom, trying to establish that armbar. He's got his arm. He's pulling. He tapped out. He got it.
Wow. Nice job by Santonio Jackson.
An armbar finish in the third round. The one-finger salute to the crowd. But he does it. Santonio Jackson, as we said, did not drive to Burlington just to mess around. Able to finish with the armbar in round number three. That was fun. know if you're Luis Gil, you're disappointed, but you've got nothing to hang your head about.
No, he put on a great fight. He just got caught. It happens to everyone. And that's what the amateurs are for. That's what it's here for, is to live and learn. That's why fighter safety is so important, because these guys are learning.
Well, we just learned that Santonio Jackson knows how to apply the arm bar. We're about to learn more. To make it official, let's send it cage side and to our ring announcer, Nick Ryan.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight ends 59 seconds into the third round. Your winner
by armbar from the blue corner, Santonio Jackson. Great job, able to get the armbar finish in round number three. We talked about how